Good morning, children. Welcome to our online classes for the academic year 2021 to 2022. This is Venugopal, your new English teacher. So here let us discuss the first lesson, the snake and the mirror. Written by Vaikam Muhammad Bashir. Vaikam Muhammad Bashir was born in the year 1908. And died in the year 1994. So who was Vaikam Muhammad Bashir? He was a Keralite. Okay, he was a poet from Kerala, a Malayalam poet from the state of Kerala. He was a humanist. He was a short story writer. He was a great novelist, and he is very well noted for his down-to-earth writings. His writings are very simple, so that's why they are worldwide popular. Yes. So this is all about the writer. And here, this lesson, let us come to this lesson. So when it comes to the lesson, the snake and the mirror, it is an experience in the life of our a doctor. Okay? And Vaikam Muhammad Bashir, he listens to the experience narrated by the doctor, and let us see what is that experience that happened in the life of the doctor. Yes. So here the lesson starts with here the doctor asking a question. He asks one question: has a snake ever coiled to any one of the party of the question? And that too a full-blooded cobra? Yes. So everyone fell silent. A full-blooded cobra. So everyone fell silent. Everyone fell silent. Even the writer also. They were listening to the story narrated by the doctor. So he starts his narration. So one day, it was a hot summer day, about 10 o'clock in the night. He had his meal at the restaurant, and he came to his house, and as he opened the door, he heard a sound from the above. So what is that sound? So it is the sound of rats and mice. So one could easily say that he shared the room with rats and mice. Yes. So he took out a box of matches and lighted a kerosene lamp and kept it on a table. Yes. So the room was not electrified. It was not electrified. Means there was no electricity. Yes. It was a rented room, and he was new to this medical profession, and his earnings were also very meager. Meager means very little. His earnings were also very meager, and he was a new medical practitioner. Yes. So he had about 60 rupees in his suitcase, and along with some shorts and dhotis, he had a black solitary coat. Solitary means single. Means he had only one coat, black coat, which he was then wearing. Okay? Yes. So he took off his shirt and his coat and not so white vest, and hung them up. He opened the two windows. It was a room. It was an outer room It was an outer room with one wall facing the open yard. Yes. So it had a tiled roof also. So just he made all the arrangements to sleep. He tried to sleep, but he could not sleep. So that's why he went out to have some air, but even at that time there was no air also. So that's why he came inside of the house and was seated on his chair, and he opened a book to read. The book name was Materia Medica. Yes. So he started reading the book. He started reading the book, and then just happened to go to a mirror. So there was a mirror there, and there lay a small comb. So you know that one feels tempted when there is a mirror in front of us. So he was greatly attracted by the mirror. So he tried to look into that. Yes. So when he looked into that mirror, and just he took a decision that he would shave daily and grow a thin mustache. Yes. So after taking this decision, again he turned and looked into the mirror. Now this time, and he felt that his smile was very attractive, and immediately he took an earth-shaking decision. Earth-shaking decision means an important decision. What is that? That he would keep the same smile every day, because he was a doctor, and that too on the top of it, he was a bachelor. He was a bachelor. Bachelor means he was an unmarried person. He was a bachelor. Yes. So, and after that, he came to his house, inside of the house, and tried to sleep, but still he could not sleep. Again, this time he would take one more decision. He would take one more decision that he would marry a doctor. Yes, he would marry. So whom he would try to marry? He would try to marry a lady doctor who had a lot of money and lot of medical practice. Yes, and for a reason, she should be a fat. So what is that reason? If he made any mistake and had to run away from her, so she should not be able to run after her. So that is very really funny thing here. Yes. So after that, after taking that decision, he again tried to sleep. Yes. So just he got up and took his seat on his chair, and he tried to move. This time he did not hear anything. Yes. So he tried to move. Just at that time, suddenly he heard that something fell from the above, just like a rubber tube. Yes, just like a rubber tube. And just at the time he tried to move, and his moving and that object falling from the above, just it happened simultaneously. Yes. So both happened simultaneously, and then he observed that a snake just fallen on his shoulder. Yes. So just he did not cry out, he did not move, and he did not tremble. Tremble means shake. Tremble means shake. He did not shake, because he had no time to do such a thing. Yes. So he was not nervous, and he kept quiet here. The snake now slowly slithered along with his left arm and coiled there. And there, he felt that death was very near to him, because his head was just 4 inches away from him. So he was in very miserable condition. Yes, so let us see what will happen in our next video. Thank you very much.